Let's go roll here. Hello beauties, hello champions. I just wanted to come to you guys on hump day and talk to you about a subject that kind of came up last night. Talking to an old friend, and we started to talk about our philosophy on love and life and relationships and all of those great things. So I'm talking to the women, but I want the men to shoot in their opinion as well. Women, are you holding off on doing certain things until you get into a loving relationship or waiting till you get married? Are there things in your life that you have postponed because you don't have a significant other? I just want to talk to that. If you are waiting to, say, travel, you're waiting to accomplish great things, buy a home, do all this stuff because you don't have a man in your life, why? Okay, if you are over 25 years old and you're still at that waiting period, like, I'm not gonna go to Hawaii because I want to save Hawaii for my honeymoon, and you can afford to go to Hawaii, why are you waiting? Why? What if you don't get married for another 10 or so years? Are you going to not enjoy Hawaii because you don't have a husband to enjoy it with? I just wonder about that. I have had friends that have postponed things in their life. I've had, people I just know, associates, that have postponed things in their life because they are waiting for the perfect man to come in and then to start living. That's the same thing I think about people that are trying to lose weight. They're not living because they are waiting till they get to the perfect size. They can wear the perfect dress, the perfect pair of pants. Why are you waiting to live? Life is going on without you. Nothing is waiting for you to get ready to live. So you have to live each day as if it's your last day. Because you don't know that might be your last day, or something can happen to you that then you can't do these things you've put off. Or what about if you wake up and you're 50 and you haven't done the traveling, you haven't put on the cute dress, you haven't gone to the beach because you're not the perfect size, you don't have the man on your hip, side to go with you. Then you have all these regrets. Are you waiting to live? Are you? Because I think that waiting to live is such a crazy thing to do. Because life is still going on without you. If you're waiting to live till you get to be a size 10 and you happen to be a size 18, what's gonna change when you're a 10? Your life is still going to be your life. You'll probably still have the same job. You'll probably still have the same home. You'll probably still have the same people in your life. What's going to change? What I do say is, as you're going through these changes to change your body, to get healthy or whatever, you start to cleanse yourself of certain things in your life. That can be people, that can be circumstances, it can be behaviors, habits, whatever. You cleanse yourself of those, but you don't stop living. You continue to live through the process. And I say to all of you that are waiting to be in love to travel, you're waiting to be in love to go to a certain restaurant, you're waiting to be in love to experience something that you just said, oh, I see myself doing that with my husband. What if you don't get that husband? What if you don't get that wife? For you men, what if you don't get the wife? Then are you never going to travel? Are you never going to go to Hawaii? Are you never going to go to Paris because you don't have someone to share it with? Okay, let's say you've done all of that and you've gone to Paris, you've done Hawaii, you've done Italy, you've done all of that. Then you get married and your husband says, let's go to our honeymoon in Hawaii. Are you not going to go because you've been to Hawaii? What craziness are we living? You can still go to Hawaii again once you get married. It will be a different experience because you will be experiencing it with someone different. Your mood will be different. Your changes in your life will be different. Guys, do not wait to live. Live now. Single women, live now. Love now. Create now. Do not wait for someone to come in your life to live. And let me ask this question. Are you women, strong, positive, professional, courageous women? Are you thinking you're incomplete because you don't have a man in your life? Are you waiting for somebody to complete you? That is some bull crap, okay? Bull crap. You have to be a complete person for someone to love you the way you should be loved. So please do not walk around here saying you're waiting for somebody to complete you and make you whole. If you're not whole, you need to start searching those things and make yourself whole. Whatever the gaps are in your life, you need to deal with that now. Because the person that come in your life, they only reflect what you are. And those things that you don't have in your life, they push you to become and to get better. That's what a good relationship is. You know, it's challenging and they push you to the edge, but it's about growth. So guys, that's what I want to say. Please do not wait to live. And please do not walk around thinking you're not whole because you don't have a man. Okay? This just really got under my nerve. And, you know, I see this so much with women. Waiting to live. Oh, he's my everything. He's my all. What? It's great to have someone in your life. It's great to have love in your life. It's a wonderful thing to do. But don't wait for it before you step out and reach those goals you want, to buy the home you want, to travel the places you want, to lose the weight you want. Don't wait to live. And if you feel incomplete, study, read, cancel, whatever you need to do to get complete. Because if you're an incomplete person, the person that you draw to you is going to treat you like crap because he knows you don't love yourself. So love yourself, be complete, and enjoy your singleness. It's the only time that you can go anywhere you want, anytime you want, without any thought to anybody else. You can get up at 12 o'clock at night, take a flight to California, and stay 3 or 4 days and come back and nobody the wiser. They can say, oh, where were you? California. Why you went? Because I wanted to. You don't have to explain and talk about the money and this, that, and the other. You can do it. You just get up and do it. But when you have somebody in your life, you have to consider them. Oh, well, it might not be a good time because he might have this and he might need me for this, or I need to help do this and we don't have the money for that. But when you're single, you can just jump up and do these things and go ahead, do it, live, do it, live. That's all I have to say. As you can tell, I'm very passionate about this one thing about life, because life is for living. We don't get a second chance. We don't get a second chance. This is it. This is it. This is not a rehearsal. This is it. This is Jay of NappyBeauty sounding out. Let's talk about hair, baby. Let's talk about kinks and naps and all that stuff. Let's talk about hair. I can barely get this song out because I'm so caught up in this moment. Guys, live. Please live. Keep it moving. Keep it positive. This is Jay.